text, they pay you for it, you give them permission to post it on their website. What if someone copy this text and use it?
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
Yeah, hi, welcome to this video. In this video, we're gonna answer the question, what does copyright protect? I'm gonna give you a couple of examples so you see what copyright really is and how it works in the practice. And if you have a question about it, feel free to contact me on Discord. And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Let's begin. So if you look at copyright, in a couple of videos ago, we talked about copyright. I show you what it is, so the definition. But here we're gonna look at that, what copyright protect. The thing is, I don't like the word protect because, like I said in another video, copyright is a right. Whatever you do something is up to you. If you do not protect your work, then you have a problem. But if you take action, you're protecting it. It's not that copyright is protecting it automatically. It's not like if someone uses it, the SWAT team is gonna go after them. Bad example, but I hope you understand what I mean. There's no automatic in here. No, there isn't. So what we're going to do here is I want to show you some examples that in that situation you need to take action. If you do not take action, you have a problem, but it's up to you. Yeah, so let's go to the drawing board. So you see here, last time we talked about copyright. We talk about what copyright is and some important thing about copyright. And this is a Dutch translation. Oh, this is the official Dutch law. And this is translation. But the question is, what does copyright protect? I'm going to give you some three examples that we're going to discuss. And based on these three examples, hopefully you can find out that copyright doesn't protect anything. But it's up to you that you need to take action or not. So let's look at example number one. Yeah, let's say you create a picture of someone. So let's say you create a picture of someone and you put it on the internet. People can buy that picture and you earn money from it, right? You earn money. Let's say if people buy it, you won. Every time people download it or buy it, you earn, let's say, $1. Yeah, sometimes $5, but let's keep it one. It's example number one. Yeah. The thing is, you sell it through an agency. Agent. Yeah, you sell it through the agent. Second, let's say you have a picture, but you sell it through your own website, so not an agent, so your own website. People can buy your picture, so they do not download it, they buy it. Sometimes they buy a collection. You are the photographer, you take a picture, they buy a collection and they can print it, they pay you. So let's say $25 for a collection. I do not know the price in those things, but it's not about the price, it's just about the way how it works. Yeah. Second, so that we talk about the second. The third, let's say you draw something. Or let's say you create a text and you create it for a company and they post it on their website, right? So here we have company website. Bad drawing, but okay. And here we have photographer, and then people buy collection. Yeah. And here we have you selling picture through an agent on a website. So we have you. Doesn't matter if you're amateur or normal photographers, that's it. We have three examples here. The question in this video is, what does copyright protect? As soon as you create a picture, you give the agents the rights to sell your pictures, all those things, is you give them a right. You give them a right to sell your pictures. You also give them a right to make it public so they can sell the picture, so people can download it, and so you can earn money. Yeah? So you are giving something. When you look at copyright, in this case, you have a right. Give me a second. Wait. Something is wrong with this pen. Let me change it. When you look at copyright, you have a right. And it can be limited by the law. So let's say it can be limited. It's that kind of situation. But you can give people still the kind of rights. The rights to sell your product. Let's say your picture in this case. The right to make it public. And that's it. So we talk only about the rights. But when someone used this picture, you need to take action. So when someone didn't buy the picture, but they copy it from the agent's website and use it, you need to take action. If you do not take action, you're not protecting anything. And by action, I mean, you're going to look online who's using your picture without a license, and then sue them or send them a letter. Give them a warning. Because if you do not do that, a lot of people are telling me, why should I pay for the picture while I can use it for free? And when a lot of people are doing it, you can go after a lot of people, but most of the time you do not have money for that. Most of the time, most people do not have money to go after those people. So copyright doesn't protect anything. You just give right to certain kind of people to sell your pictures, but it's also up to you to take action or not. Sometimes in the agreement with the agent, they will put, we will take action on behalf of you, of the revenue we will get this much percentage. So they will take action in order to protect your rights, because they'll be like, okay, this is income for me, so I need to also protect it. So copyright doesn't protect anything. It's all about you. If you look at another example, that's why I wanted to give you three examples to show you. Imagine you're a photographer, you have a collection, you have on your website, you did a client work, and you made a collection on your website. Client will be like, okay, I want this collection, I want this and that picture. You order the pictures, you send it, you print it out, and you're ready to send it to your client. Okay, your client want to use them. The problem is, you see that your client, in the agreement that you send to your client, you can only use it for personal use. But then you come online, you see one of your pictures. You know it's your picture. I'm not going to in the discussion about if it may or may not be your picture. But you know it's your picture. You see it online, but another company is using that picture in their commercial. And you made a picture of the collection for the client, but not for that company. You didn't give them a right to make it public. So you'd be like, okay, what can I do about it? Send them a letter. Because you know it's your picture, you can prove it. That's one thing. Second, you didn't give him permission to do that. So send a letter, hey, can you show me a license that you have in order to use the picture for this commercial? If they cannot do that, they need to pay you for it. And the thing is, it's not a copyright protecting anything. It's you are protecting your rights. You are going to take action in order to, you are going to use your rights. You're not protecting anything. And when you use your right, technically you're protecting the pictures, protecting it from other people using it without your permission. But it's not like the thing is protecting it automatically. You need to take action. Even in this example, when someone is using your picture for commercial, you need to take action. And if you do not take action, they're going to get away with it. So here again, you have a right. It's limited by the law, but if someone uses it without your permission, you need to take action. If you do not take action, you have a problem, because someone is using your picture without your permission. And do you want that? Or do you, or are you like, okay, I don't care. Yeah, it's up to you. If you don't have the resources, sometimes there are agencies out there that work based on no queue, no pay. Because if they are certain that they can get what they want, they will take action for you. If you have more questions about this, feel free to contact me in Discord. I'm a Fritz. I will see what I can do in order to help you. If you look at the third example, you create a text, and the text is for a company, and the company posts it on their website. All right? You create a text, they pay you for it, you give them permission to post it on their website. What if someone copied this text and use it? Or what if they edit it and in this agreement, they say nothing about editing without your permission? In both cases, you need to take action. It's not like the copyright is protecting you automatically. Because it's weird, if someone edited it and you see it, it's not like they've been like, hey, you're breaking my copyright. No, no, you need to take action. If you do not take action, nothing's going to happen. So here again, you will see that in a third situation, you need to take action and make sure that they follow the rules that you put in the agreement. But most of the time when they edit the text, most copyright people are like, okay, I don't care. I got paid for it. Let's go to the next job. But some people put some pride into the creation of those texts. So they be like, hey, you're not going to change it without my permission because my name on it. You understand that? So if you look in all three examples, I hope you can see that copyright is protecting anything. It's up to you if you're going to enforce your right or not. Enforce means you're going to take action or not. So copyright doesn't protect anything. And in all those three examples, I just show you, hey, you need to take action. If you do not take action, you have a problem. So I hope you can see that copyright doesn't protect anything. It's up to you if you're going to enforce your right or not. And if you look at the definition of copyright in the Dutch law, it's up to you. You have the right to do certain kind of things, but there are limitations by the law. But it's not like everything is automatically protected. No, it doesn't work like that. You need to make sure that you take action when you need to take action. If you do not take action, or if someone doesn't take action, that doesn't mean you have permission. But that's something we'll talk about it in another video. If you have questions about copyright or anything related to copyright, feel free to contact me on Discord. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you in the next video.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me?